So good morning to all of you. We will continue with this talk on You Are a Soul. We already discussed three fields of investigation. The first one was near-death experience studies. Second was this hypnotic regression. And the third one we discussed was Edgar Cayce's cases. Now we have two more fields which I would discuss now. The first one is reincarnation cases. Reincarnation, as you know, is the same soul taking body and coming back to earth. And this is done by Trutz Hardo. And a few cases are discussed here. Another scientist who has done a lot of work on reincarnation is Ian Stevenson. His stories are also very interesting. And what they do is, of course, children immediately after being born, that means within the age of 10, tell about their previous life. And they will give stories, and then people first disbelieve. Then finally someone like Ian Stevenson and somebody comes and says, let us find out if these are true. Then they search, find out the places. And then many times this child is able to identify the past relatives. Like father, if he had a wife, he will say, this is my wife, all that. And then of course the truth is established. That is what they say. And the continuity of the consciousness is established. So we again come to the conclusion that there is a soul. So that's what is done in reincarnation studies. I personally have met one girl long back. She used to say, my father's house is near a beach, but this place is not near a beach at all. So she had that memory. But of course, these parents were told by the doctor not to encourage her to continue speaking. And obviously, so the matter ended there. So there was no further discovery. So that's what it is. And then next one is, of course, a series of books. The first one is Life After Death. This is written by Neville Randall. And this Neville Randall book is a little interesting because they directly spoke to people who are in the other world. So they have not taken another birth, but they are now in the transitory world. And stories of that world is what is told. In fact, interestingly, they developed a device by which what the souls speak could be recorded. So it is all available as records, not just somebody saying I heard this and so on, but real recording was done of those talks, and then they analyzed those records, and of course through that they again established that the soul continues, there is a life after death also. So that's what that book is all about. Next is two books, both are Indian authors. So I don't know if you believe Indian authors. This is Law of the Spirit World, written by one lady by name Khurshid Bhavnagri. This is one book. Second book is also senior advocate of the Supreme Court, Hira Lal Kaji. So in both these books, first of course, Khurshid Bhavnagri, her two sons died in a car accident. In fact, these sons were motor enthusiasts and they were going for a race and they were practicing to go for the race. And then, of course, they lost control. The car hit a tree and they died on the spot. And she was by that time quite old, and suddenly losing both the sons, and they are so old, of course, the husband also is there, was a terrible thing for them. And what happened was, the sons, this happened in Bombay. There was a, what we call medium. Medium means one who can directly talk to the soul in the other world. So her sons contacted this lady, this medium, through another soul and said, we would like to talk to our mother, so please invite her to your house and so on. So mother was called, and then mother spoke to the children. And then they finally learned how to communicate without the medium. And then one thing they used was Ouija board. Other one they call it active writing. So they will get the thought in their mind and then they will write, that level. I don't want to stress more on that. But what is written is really wonderful. Especially this Bhavanagiri's book is worth reading because it explains some of the world there, how people get tortured and not tortured. Very, very interesting book, and I think it is mostly true. And of course, these people also had to have the permission of the higher spirits to speak to the mother about all these things also. So that establishes again this soul, existence of a soul. And I think that's all the evidence I have now so far. And then, of course, our Puranas have enough and more number of stories about past lives, future lives, and so on. Like everyone, when they suffer something, they will say, past life he behaved like this, that's why he is suffering now. In fact, all Puranas will have stories like that, past life, relating a present life misery to a past life action. Like Dasharatha, when they start also, it starts saying that Dasharatha kills that couple's, I mean, the Rishi couple's son, and so that's why he has to finally see separation from Rama and so on. I mean, so they are related, I mean, the karmic conditions are related, and past life to present life also are presented. Of course, you have to read the whole Puranas to find out those detailed stories. And so that's it. So we will accept those who accepted what I have said and accepted the honesty of these others now can believe that you are souls and not the body. So if you can really intellectually at least understand this, later maybe you can experientially understand it. Of course, I will also come with the books by masters and how you can probably practice meditation and so on and reach that level. So thank you so much.